If a cavity is the thickness between the two skins of glass in a glazed unit, an edge spacer is the bit that goes all around the outside, and that's what holds the two pieces of glass apart. Basically, the edge spacer determines the cavity width. Linking back to what we said about air being a great insulator, the moment you put a edge seal around a unit, you're creating what they call a cold bridge. Instead of air, a nice insulation of air, you've got your edge seal of plastic or metal or whatever it is directly touching both skins of glass, and it allows heat to transfer through. For that reason, in any double glazed unit, the outside edge bit is always the coldest bit of it. Now, you'll see that quite often older double glazed windows, and you get condensation building up just around the perimeter of the window. Talking about cold bridges, and you know, air's a great insulator, metal, rubbish insulator. Basically, that's why it's cold to the touch. It transfers heat away very quickly. A metal edge spacer is transferring the heat from your house directly across the two bits of glass, out through the metal, out to the outside air. It's cold. So when double glazed units first came on the market, they would tend to be using an aluminium edge spacer, metal. They've moved on from that, and now the highest performance edge spacer is what we call a warm edge spacer. Now, it's basically made of plastic, and they have like a desiccant in them. Desiccant just to take moisture out of any air that's in the unit. Warm edge spacer gives you the best insulation. They come in different colors. Typically, you've got white and black warm edge. You can get gray warm edge, but white and black are the ones we most commonly use. As a general rule, for us, it's warm edge spacers all the way. It's better performance, not a great deal of additional cost. When you're talking about the insulation value of windows in terms of U values, your edge spacer does come into play, and it does have significant impact. And when you count that up over loads of windows over a whole house, that can have quite a lot of impact. So talking about the edge spacers and edge seals, so we're kind of talking about the thickness of unit, I'll call it the width of the edge spacer. And then there's the other dimension, so height of edge spacer. That's really important, because when you're creating a double glazed unit, you're basically sticking these two skins of glass with the edge spacer, and they're bonded to the edge spacer. So you're looking for that seal to keep the unit integral, and that's basically how long it's going to last. Double glazed unit has to be airtight. As soon as they're not airtight, air starts creeping in there, the moisture in the air gets condensed on the inside surface, and that's where you get these misted, they're called blown or misted units. And it's basically, it tells you that the edge spacer has been breached. In order for the unit not to fail, it's got to stay sealed. How well it stays sealed in part depends on how well it's edge sealed. Good warm edge spacer bar will tend to have around about 12 or 13 mil height, which is a really good solid seal. It gives you good overlap with the glass to the spacer unit. Seals really nicely, get really good longevity. So units guaranteed for 10 years, but with a life expectancy, you know, realistically way beyond this. So in 15 years we've been making windows of that type of unit, I think we've known one failure. So we talked about the thickness of the edge spacer and how that varies according to your cavity, but the height of the edge spacer, like, that's not something that you have to make a choice about. That's not something we get an option about. So the only time it changes is when we're looking at a slimline, low profile unit. Now they will have a lower spacer height, so they've got much less of an edge seal. The reason for that much smaller or much lower height edge seal, which I've talked about in another video, is that it's designed to sit into a tiny traditional single glazed rebate, and if you had the edge seal any higher, then it would be visible to the eye. That's a rule of edge seals, is that they shouldn't be visible to the eye, partly because it doesn't look very good, and partly because if you present the edge seal to daylight, UV degradation can break down the edge seal. So then again, you can get a unit failure. That's just sort of standard good joinery design. I guess that's important to note, because it does sort of limit you in the case of these traditional windows with small rebates. You can't just go and put any old glazing unit in there. Hence the rise of the slimline units, which had that very low sightline spacer bar height. I have touched on this on another video, because this is a bit of a subject in its own right. In a nutshell, that's spacer bars, spacer bar thickness, and edge seals.